Hey everybody, Ryan Marrinan here for 3M. We've got questions coming in from some customers saying, hey man, we've got this bead on these Dodge trucks and caravans that we just can't seem to replicate. What is it that you have that can do this? We're gonna show you today how to replicate that bead. Let's head inside and get started. So let's show you how we're going to replicate this bead. We've got our panel prepped here. We've got our epoxy primer down. We had some bare metal that was exposed. We want to make sure that we got that covered up. I've also got my width of my bead taped out so that we've got, you know, our desired pattern, and I know what my final finish is going to look like before I even put the material on there. So for this application, we're going to use our 4274. Some of you may be familiar with this in some of our other videos. It's actually our NVH dampening foam. It's a two-part urethane. Also makes a great seam sealer as well. As always, we're gonna equalize the cartridge upright into a paper towel, making sure that we got equal dispersion of part A and B. Once we have our static mixing nozzle on and we got the ring locked down, we're gonna dispense a little bit of material out onto the mixing board. If you don't have a mixing board, you can go ahead and use that same paper towel. We just wanna make sure that we're getting it out onto a safe surface. Now with this product here, what we're looking to do is we're just gonna get the material out and we're gonna tool it in just a second. So again, you're watching me here and I'm working it inward towards the seam. Again, making sure that we've got good adhesion to the surface and that that seam is going to be sealed. Now if I need to put more material in here, I'm gonna go right next to it and I'm gonna work it into itself, right? We don't wanna pull it away or anything like that. That way we're not entering air into the material. So we're gonna work more material right into itself. And now we've got enough on the surface to replicate our bead. What I've done here is I've got a spreader that I've cut in half. I like to have quite a few of these just sort of laying around so that I can grab them on the fly and be able to replicate this bead. And all we're trying to do here is we're just gonna knock it down. We're not trying to remove any material. So we're gonna have our spreader at a very low angle. We want to make sure that our seam sealer has made it tape to tape. That's important here. The tape is actually the desired finished width that we want for that bead. So if the material's not all the way to the tape, your edge might not be as straight as what you're looking to get. Once I've got it straightened out, what I'm actually going to do here is take one of our gray Scotch-Brite pads, cut it down to a smaller size, and then we're just going to take and we're just gonna dab this over the surface while we're still in the working window. And if you get to a point where you feel like you've got too much on here, you can also just flip it inside out and keep working while the material's still wet. Again, we're just adding the texture into that surface. So for this particular bead, it's kinda got like that tape look where somebody just sort of applied it off of a roll of tape, but it's got that awkward texture, and how do you replicate it? This is what we're going for. When we're ready, we're gonna pull our tape off. And again, we're gonna pull backwards against itself. If anything, we wanna pull it inward just a little bit so that we're not creating an unnecessary wave or a shelf off the edge of the seam sealer, making it difficult for the painter to get the finished material underneath that so that we got proper corrosion protection on all sides. So as I pull this back, I'm actually gonna pull inward just a little bit and use the tape to create a nice clean cut edge. So with this bead here, you can see we've created that nice texture. We've used a very flexible product. It's got a little bit longer working window than some of our other two-part seam sealers, but that's okay if you've got a really long application to do. You've got plenty of time to work with the material, and once you're done, go ahead and walk away and let it cure. So that's it for this bead here today. If you've got any other questions about seam sealers, please visit 3M Collision Repair Academy. The link for that is in the description below. Also, check out some of the other videos on our page. If you hit subscribe and the notification bell on the corner over here, you'll be sure to get the latest videos as we're releasing them to make sure that you're up to date on the best practices in today's industry. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. I appreciate you watching, and we'll see you next time.